everyone, and welcome to Bonnie's Best Creations. And today it is so cold out here in Ontario. Our temperature goes up and down, and you never know what you're going to wake up to. I'm glad I'm not living in Sudbury like my sister. She woke up to snow. So there's no snow today, but it's cold and it's a cozy day. So I hope you'll join me, because in my cozy day, I am going to make a healthy butternut squash casserole. It's got sweet potatoes and squash. And I don't know about your family, my family is always on a diet, either to lose weight, no meat, pure vegetables, gluten-free, meat-free, oh, sugar-free. It's crazy. I'm so thankful I can eat anything, but I try to adapt my cooking to satisfy my family. So today, this recipe can be adapted to anyone. If you are vegan, you can do this. You can gluten, you can do this. And you know what? If you want an extra bonus, you know, stick around to the end, because I'm gonna make a yummy apple crisp. So come on and join me in my kitchen. We're gonna get warm, cozy, savory, and I hope you enjoy. So let's get going. As you've seen, I've done some prep work already. I have chopped my squash. I've got butternut squash, and I've cut them in reasonable, you know, uniform size, and sweet potato. And what I'm gonna do is put this on a parchment lined cookie sheet, because I'm gonna roast this. Any vegetable that is roasted is even better. There's something about that slow roasting that just brings out the goodness in that. So I'm gonna put this on my sheet. Okay, so there's my potato, sweet potato and butternut squash on my parchment paper cookie sheet. I've preheated my oven to 400, but now I'm gonna make a glaze. So to this, to my bowl, I added about, it called for about 3 or 4 tablespoons of olive oil. If whatever olive oil or whatever oil you want, if you want to use avocado oil, you do that, or sunflower, whatever you like. And then to that, I added about two tablespoons of balsamic vinegar. And to that, I'm going to add about 3 tablespoons of maple syrup. A little bit of salt. Some pepper. Teaspoon of cinnamon. And you know that I love using whole nutmeg. I'm going to put just a little bit of nutmeg in that. Not much, just a little bit of a kick. Stir that. Now this recipe also has wild rice in it. So this mixture that I've mixed, I'm gonna put half of it on my potato and squash, and then the rest of it I'm gonna add to my wild rice. So I'm gonna just drizzle that all around. there and reserve that. And I'm just going to use my hands. And I'm going to roast this in the oven till they're tender, probably about 20 minutes. I'm going to make sure that all this gets coated. Now, I'm going to tell you that you can buy already cut up squash at the grocery store. You don't have to stand and cut it. Save yourself some energy if you want to do that. But I just happen to have a squash downstairs, so I'm using that. So there we are. It's all coated. So I'm going to pop that in the oven and roast away. Okay, so I said that I also was going to make an apple crisp. So while I was chopping my potatoes and my squash, I decided to chop my apples. And so I did all that all at one time. And to kind of stop them from going yellow, I've added lemon juice. So I'm just going to put that in my baking dish. And then in the meantime, I'm going to mix my top for my crisp. And I've got about a quarter cup of margarine or butter, whatever you want, to that. I'm going to add about maybe a half a cup of flour, and to that maybe a third of a cup of brown sugar, and then I like to use oats and of course cinnamon. And I will even sprinkle some cinnamon. You know what? Baking is good that you can, nothing has to be really exact. It's to your taste. And I'm just going to mix that. I make this crumble a lot. And I go, you know what? I'm a different kind of a cook. I go by taste. I go by taste. And the consistency. I want it to be kind of wet when I pinch it together with my fingers, but yet I don't want it sopping because the juice of the apples. See, now I'm gonna add a few more oats to that because it's a little bit dry, so just a little bit at a time. And then I'm going to taste it. A little bit more cinnamon. That's pretty good. And then what I'm going to do is pack this on top. This crumble is great for on top of a apple pie. You know, have a pie crust bottom and then a crumble on top of your apple pie. I will do that a lot. And then that would bake in the oven for about, until those apples are tender, maybe 45 minutes. And quick and easy, but delicious. Okay, I have my water boiling here on my pot, in my pot for my rice. And I have a mixed blend of wild rice, brown rice. I bought this bag from Costco, and so it's a nice mix. So I'm gonna add that to my rice, to my water, and to that water I'm gonna add the rest of my, remember that mixture I put on my sweet potato? So I've got that, and I'm gonna bring that to a boil and then let it simmer for 20 minutes. Okay, to my rice that's pretty well done, I'm adding about a half a cup of raisins and three quarters of a cup of dried cranberries. I'm just gonna put that in there, stir it around, and I'm gonna put the lid on and let that steam just to plump up those raisins and cranberries. All right, so there is my squash and my sweet potato that I've roasted, and it did take about 40 minutes so that they're nice crusted on the outside. And halfway through I did just with a spatula move them around. So I'm going to put that all in a bowl. And then here I have my rice and my cranberries and raisins, and I'm just going to add that. And just stir that. Now you can add whatever protein you want to this. You can add chicken, you can add nuts, you can add any kind of beans if you want chickpeas. And I'm just gonna mix that and then taste just to make sure it doesn't need any more seasoning. No, that's perfect. So what I'm going to do with this is put it in my baking pan and cover it with foil till it's ready to serve. And there you have a delicious side dish to any meal you might have, or have it for lunch, or whatever way you want to do that. So I hope you give that a try. And then also there is my baked apple crisp, juicy apples, nice topping on top. So there is a meal that was put together pretty quickly. So I hope you give this a try. Please, any questions, ask me. I would love to hear from you if you've tried this, if you like it, and thanks for watching.